So I welcome all of you in today's session. Today we have very energetic and dedicated PhD student from IIT Kanpur with us, Mr. Shubham Kumar. Shubham did his BSc from Garhwal University, Uttarakhand, and after that he did his master's in chemistry from IIT ISM Dhanbad. And after masters, he cleared all the major exams of chemistry like CSIR, NET, and GATE, and get very good rank in those exams. And now currently he is doing his PhD in IIT Kanpur in Professor Dethe's lab in total synthesis of bioactive natural products. So over to you, Shubham. All the best.
So thank you so much, Nitin, for your kind introduction, and I'm again thankful to Dr. Ramkaran sir to join us for today's session. And today my topic is the total synthesis of the menthol. So you have seen this molecule, and this is a very important molecule for the synthetic as well as the structure point of view. So you will see here, this is the as compared to other natural product, this is the very small molecule and having three chiral centers there. So first of all, I will come to the introduction section. Okay, 1 minute. Okay, so introduction, menthol is a major constituent of the peppermint and other mints oil and widely utilized in terpenes and finding the confectionery, perfume in liquids and cough drops and cigarette, toothpaste, nasal. And you have seen the menthol soap, which is famous for the trend. And in organic synthesis point of view, this is the naturally occurring substance convenient source for the chirality. So I have already discussed there is the three chiral centers in the molecule. There are several methods was published to synthesize this molecule, but I have taken the Takasaka group process in which they took S-binum as a catalyst and to proceed the reaction. So come to the electrosynthetic portion of this molecule. So this is the molecule having the three chiral center like this is and this. So these three chiral center, and if we took the hydrogenation reaction which takes place, so this molecule after the hydrogenation we are getting this molecule. And if we talk about this molecule, how this will synthesize, so this will synthesize by the carbonyl reaction. And you know what is the carbonyl reaction? So this is the elder reaction like this. So this can like go and here. So this is the elder reaction, which is also known as the carbonyl reaction. After the carbonyl reaction, we are getting this molecule from this thing. And this double bond, carbonyl double bond, is the enamine hydrolysis of this molecule. And one of the important reaction is the asymmetric isomerization, which I will discuss in detail. And the molecule number 44 is obtained from this molecule, which is the asymmetric isomerization. So this is the beauty of this chemistry. We can use the asymmetric isomerization and other process here. And this molecule is come from the telomerization reaction. So this is another class of the molecule. So we have to learn about the asymmetric isomerization as well as the telomerization of this molecule. So our starting precursor is the micelline. So we will start our synthetic target from the micelline. And after this several step, we can come to the synthesis of this molecule. So this is the, if we talk about the structure point of view, so this molecule is very much small as compared to other complex natural products. But I have taken this molecule only because of this, its beauty as well as the process involving to synthesize this molecule. So let's come to the enantho selective total synthesis of menthol. So this is the micelline. So this micelline is obtained by the thermal cracking of beta alpine. So if you're not getting the structure, so I will tell you what is the structure of this molecule. So actually this is the cyclohexane ring. And this thing. So you know that in organic chemistry, generally what happened, if we have the four member ring. So this is the four member ring is there. If four member ring and three member ring is formed in the organic chemistry, so that is the very much energetically and the strengthful molecule. So what happened? This molecule under the thermal cracking. So we could like this transformation and this transformation. So after thermal cracking of this molecule, we are getting the micelline compound 45. and this is the telomerization reaction, which I will discuss in detail. So after telomerization reaction, this compound with n-butyl lithium is a catalyst and diethyl amine compound, and we are getting IND-WID 47 compound. What is the process involving? I will draw the catalytic cycle after that. So just keep patience. And this is the molecule like this. Now what happened here? We are getting the E allylic amine. So this E allylic amine, after the reaction with the rhodium catalyst, rhodium first catalyst, and this is the binary based rhodium catalyst, and this is asymmetric isomerization. And you know this process, the scientist Nobel prize on this, for this process. I will cover this topic with detail. So after the attack of this allylic amine, we are ending with this compound. Then what happened after that? Aqueous espresso 4 was taken. So what is the role of this thing? So you all know, also know the basic reaction mechanism. This can like this and this can thing. We are ending with this compound. And after the attack of the H2, so we are finished the compound number 36. Now this is the very important reaction, which is known as the Alder reaction or carbonyl reaction. So what is the steps here? So if we draw this compound in chair form, so we are ending with this thing. So for the stable conformation of cyclohexene, we have to draw this molecule in chair, and the bulky substituent we have to put in the equatorial side. So this is the stable conformation of this molecule. This hydrogen go like this, and this double bond attack here. We are ending with the compound having the OH group like the above thing. And if we take catalytic hydrogenation of this molecule in presence of H2NaCl, there are several agents are also available, but this group took the H2NaCl, and we are ending with this compound with the enantiomeric pure and having 1, 2, 3 center are chiral. So we have to maintain the chirality of the molecule. So let's see next step. Now this is the platinum cascade reaction. So what happened in this process? So this is a new class of the mechanism. I think all of you are not aware of from this reaction. I already talked to my friends. Do you know the telomerization reaction? So telomerization reaction is very poor. So telomerization reaction is a new class of reaction for you. So what happened here? So what happened here? We start our this compound with butadiene. So this butadiene insert with the platinum catalyst. So this the platinylation reaction takes place. And after the platinylation reaction takes place, this is the CC coupling reaction. So what happened here? This platinum can attack here, and this gravel won't go like this, and this can go like this, and here, and this can attack here. So we are getting the CC coupling here. After the CC coupling, what happened here? We had took proton. So what is the role of this proton? I will tell you. The protonation takes place at the 6th number of carbon. So this, the platinization will take place, and we are getting the this pyrrolidine complex. After the attack of the nucleophile, so we have a nucleophile. Generally, in this reaction, we took the diethyl amine. So this nucleophile has choice, either it can attack this center, or either it can attack this center. So if nucleophile attack there, so we are getting the branch product. So this is the branch D dash. And if nucleophile attack on the terminal carbon, so we are getting the terminal product, linear product. And after the taking the butadiene, so this butadiene, when we took the butadiene, it completed the catalytic cycle again. And we are getting the compound having the branch molecule, always the linear molecule. So this is the new class of the mechanism. So I request all of you, please go through this articles. This is published in 2020, means this research is not so old, and this is the hot topic. So I request all of you, if you are more interested in telomerization reaction, you can read this article. There's clearly defined what is the mechanism, what are the role of the nucleophile and other things you can find here. So this is the basically based on telomerization reaction. So telomerization reaction is one of the important class of mechanism. So I have covered this thing. Okay. So if I stop my talk here and say to thank you to you, so I think it will not be worthy to all of you because you have joined here. So this is not my final thank you. So I will start my topic now. So this is the asymmetricity in the total synthesis, because I already mentioned in our cyclogen system, there are the three chiral center. So we have to emphasize the asymmetricity. So what is the role of the asymmetric compound? What is the asymmetric synthesis and how it is useful for the total synthesis people? So this talk I will mention here. This talk I dedicated to my friend, and she is working in asymmetric catalysis. So she is nowadays very much frustrated because lab is not opening in IIT Kanpur. So I thought to emphasize and acknowledge, encourage her to be in the field of the asymmetric synthesis, because this field is very much interesting and very much challenging as well as, and how this asymmetric synthesis is helpful for total synthesis people. That's why I want to say the gratitude to total asymmetric synthesis. So first thing came into our mind, what is the asymmetric synthesis? So I will start my talk here. So we use gloves and socks. So first question I will ask you, how many of you people care about the wear gloves and socks without any don't care? So if we talk, if we answer to myself, so I wear my socks without any don't care, because both socks are same. We can use in left hand and right hand. We don't care about this thing. But if I talk to gloves, so what happened here? We always think about this thing. Our left hand gloves is only for left hand and right hand gloves for right hand. So what does it mean? Why we cannot use our left hand glove for right hand glove for left hand, as we did for the socks? So this is the interesting thing, and this is, I can say, there's the journey of the asymmetric synthesis. Because if you see our hand, this thing, so this hand is the means the chirality is there. So what are the chirality? This is the non-superimposed mirror image to one another. If we stand in front of the mirror and if we say our left right hand, so our left hand is just mirror image of the left hand. And this mirror image, how can we say that? This is the non-superimposed. If I superimpose this hand to this hand, so this is the hand, this is my thumb, which is not superimposed to this. So that is why those compounds which are non-superimposed mirror images to each other, they are basically called the chiral compound. And chirality in the organic synthesis is one of the most important topics. And nowadays, this is the one of the best, one of the most important topics. So that is why we always wear our gloves in right hand to right hand and left hand gloves to left hand. But in our socks, there is the chiral, this symmetrical molecule. And this is the, like we can say that plane of symmetry is present. That is why our socks are asymmetric, optically inactive. Now this is a three-dimensional representation. So if we talk about our tetrahedral compound, so I took example of the L-aniline and R-aniline. So basically these two compounds are same, but their spectral arrangement is different. That is why if we talk the mirror image, the both compound are mirror image to each other. So this is the enantiomeric compound, and this is the alien compound actually in 3D form. But if we talk about this thing, so there are two planes present, and I think the point group is T2D. So this belongs to the T2D point group due to presence of one plane is horizontal and second plane is vertical. So this is the, now I direct your interest here. So you have seen that you always know about the nimbu, santra, jeera, pudina, all these things are related to our daily life. But what happened if we talk about the asymmetric synthesis point of view? So you can see here, the all compound is same, but just talk about this center and this center. So if we talk about this center, so what happened here? So this is the below the plane, and this is the above the plane. So this is the beta alpha carbon. Due to presence of the alpha carbon, we are ended with nimbu. And if we have the beta carbon, we are ending with orange. So you can understand what is the importance and how this is the fascinated to all of us, because we are the chemistry people. So we have to deal with the atmosphere. We have to deal with the surrounding. We have to deal with the daily life. So that is why this is the, and if we talk about this compound, this is the carbon. So if this group is below and this group is above. Only just because of this thing, this smell like a caraway seeds and this smell like a spearmint. So just changing the one chiral center here, how the property is changing. So this is the beauty of this thing. Now next thing is that, so I start the asymmetric, the use of asymmetric synthesis in medicinal chemistry. So thalidomide is start a drug in Germany 1950 to 1960. So this drug was very much popular, and this drug was for the cure of the morning sickness of pregnant lady. So what they did, they took a thalidomide, and what the result that when that thalidomide was used in 10 years, there was the use, what we can say, that cause was happening. There was several diseases was happening, and the newborn baby who's been there, so they was the physically disabled. You can see there the pigs. So what has happened here? So if you have to know about the answer, so we have to just see the structure of the thalidomide. So this is basically thalidomide drugs. So you can see here, this chiral, this center and this center. So both center, if we talk about thalidomide, the both center are changed. One has the below one, don't think about this because it's a mirror image. If you see here, so this will be the below side. So one R form of the thalidomide is sedative for the pregnant woman, while the S form of the drugs are the kept as a tetrogenic. So it creates the physical disability in the newborn baby. So people are finding out what is happening there, and finally they stop the distributing of this thalidomide drugs, and they people and chemists are very much fascinated for the synthesis of the chiral drug. Now what is target of the medicinal chemist? So medicinal chemist always try to maintain to get away from the chirality. They always seeking a drug in which chirality is present is very much less, because if the chirality is increased, so we have to use more care about this thing. We have to separate the compound, and also the cost of the drug become very much high. So what happened there? Nowadays, medicinal chemistry always make a molecule just care about the little number of the chiral region, because if there is a one center, so how this react means, if there's the R, so there's sedative, and other part also causing the tetrogenic in nature. So that is why medicinal chemistry is too much important. Now I will talk about the L-DOPA. So again, this is the very much important, only one chiral center is changed, L-DOPA. And this is the D-DOPA. So D-DOPA is toxic, while the L-DOPA is the single enantiomer for treated for the Parkinson diseases. And again, molecule is the cortisinin A. It was synthesized by Baran group, and it's one of the eminent scientists in the field of the total synthesis. So you can, if you want to more detail, you can go through this journal. So you can see there, this is the beta carbon is there. So this is the beta substitution, and this is the alpha substitution. So in beta substitution, you can find that this is the inhibitor, while the alpha substitution is inactive for this drug. So now you can see there what is the role of the asymmetric synthesis, how asymmetric synthesis is important for the medicinal chemistry and synthetic chemistry and all these things. Now, how can we achieve the asymmetric synthesis? So we have to make a chiral asymmetric synthesis, also known as the chiral synthesis, and we have a starting metal in product. So in asymmetric synthesis process, what happened? If we have chiral substance, that's okay, fine. But if we have chiral or achiral, so both kind of substance, if we have chiral substance, then it's very good for us. But if we don't have the chiral substance, so what is our target? We have to make always chiral product. So we have to check the chirality of the product. So we have to focus on the how can we make the high number of the chirality in a compound. So that is why asymmetric synthesis. So what is the terminology here? This is chiral oxalate process, chiral pool synthesis, chiral regulation, enantioselective or organocatalysis, biocatalysis. And biocatalysis, I can say with you, Dr. Ramkaran sir work in the biocatalysis. So if you have any doubts in the last section, if I'm not able to answer, then I request to sir, please elaborate about this thing. What is the biocatalyst? How enzyme can work in our body and make a single enantiomers? And this is the asymmetric catalysis. So this is the all tool for the asymmetric synthesis. And I will not go in detail because it is a huge chemistry. So I just give you surface and surface knowledge so that you can drag your interest in the field of the asymmetric synthesis or organic synthesis. So in catalytic asymmetric synthesis, what happened? We took a small amount of the enantiomeric pure compound. So that will be the catalyst. This catalyst may be enzymology, which work Ramakrishnan sir did, Ramakrishnan doing, and synthetic portion or soluble metal catalyzed complex. So this is the starting precursor, and we have to make a chiral compound. And our starting precursor, which we are going to start, that should be chiral or achiral. इस समय कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ेगा कि our starting metal chiral है या achiral है. But our target is that we have to make chiral compound. So this is our target. In the recent years, chemists were developing the new methods catalytic asymmetry process and transform the prochiral. So prochiral means what is the prochiral? As before the chirality. So our starting metal is prochiral, but when we make the final product, that time chirality must be maintained. We start with prochiral substrate into the chiral with impressive margin and enantiomer selectivity. So early success of story in the field of the asymmetric synthesis of the Monsanto process. So that process was very much famous, and one of the scientists got Nobel Prize for this process. I will talk about this thing. So if we talk about the catalytic asymmetric reaction, so first thing in coming to our mind, Wilkinson catalyst. So we will start our PSC and MSc. So we are very much fascinated by the Wilkinson catalyst. So this is the Sir Geoffrey Wilkinson. And if we talk about the catalyst, so this is rhodium-based catalyst. So RH, PPH3, O3Cl. So this is our Wilkinson catalyst having the rhodium present in the plus one state. So if you talk about the catalytic cycles, so I'm not going in detail. So just what happened here, we have a sodium catalyst. This is the 14 electron species undergo the oxidative addition of H2 and getting this thing. After the attack of the alkene here, so we are getting the carbometallization takes place, and this is the process within the beta hydrogen, this process, and after the reductive elimination, we are getting this ending with this product. So what happened here? Any alkene is reduced into the alkene product. What is the reactivity? So always keep in mind, Wilkinson catalyst always reduced to less substituted alkene, like this. So you know much more about this thing. So I'm not going in detail. So I pick up some example having Wilkinson catalyst act as. So I already told you Wilkinson catalyst always act in a low, less interposition. So we have two double bond, one is. So Wilkinson catalyst always reduce this one, not this one. And if we have this thing, so again we have, this is the bulky, this is less bulky. So it will going to reduce. And if we have the alpha beta unsaturated and isolated alkene. So in case of the Wilkinson catalyst, we are ending with this product, having the reduce of this thing. And if we start with liquid ammonia, we are ending with this. This is the 1,4 type of addition. And if we start this compound, so if we take H2PT, other hydrogenation reaction, so what happened? This nitro as well as the double bond, both things are reduced. But in case of Wilkinson reaction, this is the highly selective. So it reduces only double bond, and our nitro group is remain in the reaction. Okay, if we start this compound here, so we are getting double bond, and here is the single bond compound. So this is the beauty of the Wilkinson catalyst. Now, in enantiomer selective synthesis of L-DOPA. So L-DOPA is the drugs used for the Parkinson diseases, and this is the W.S. Nowell. So this is the one of the most important person, and he got Nobel Prize in 2001. I will discuss about him. This is the Monsanto process. So he started this process. So synthesis of L-DOPA started with compound number 2, and we took this RR rhodium RR dimer cyclooctadiene, this complex, and this is the catalytic asymmetric hydrogenation. After the hydrogenation, we are selectivity gas 99% enantiomeric access with compound, and we are getting the L-DOPA. And L-DOPA is one of the important for the synthetic precursor of the aspartame. So This is the beauty of the asymmetric hydrogenation. Okay. And so this is aspartame, it's artificial sweetener, we can say that. And the synthesis portion is like this. So again, we start with compound number 5 and catalytic asymmetric hydrogenation takes place. And after the acidic workup, we end up with the L-DOPA, which we have synthesized. And I have already discussed in slide last slide. And this L-DOPA treated with aspartic acid. So aspartic acid and L-DOPA when mix up, so this is the peptide coupling reaction takes place. So make a aspartame compound. So this is the aspartame synthesis, and which is the most important tool. The tool was the asymmetric catalytic hydrogenation, and this is the artificial sweetener. So next is the asymmetric thing is there. So look at here. So if I will say that I can take the Z allylic amine as well as the E allylic amine. So what happened here? Z allylic amine, what is the reagent for this conversion? So that we can get this stereo center, because this is the prochiral center. That is called prochiral center. But after the reaction, we are getting the chiral tear. But that is the step which is called prochiral center. So this so we are starting with Z allylic amine or E allylic amine. So you can see here, always this reaction is stereo specific. So what is the reagent? I will discuss here. So you can use this Noyori catalyst. Noyori again another Nobel Prize in chemistry. And so what happened here? If we start Z allylic amine or E allylic amine. So Reeves should rule the thumb rule. So if we start with Z allylic amine or E allylic amine, and we took the S binep as a catalyst, so we are ending with the. So you can see here one thing I want to discuss. Always either you have Z allylic amine or E allylic amine, you are ending with the E person. So you are ending with E. So this is called stereo specific reaction. So this is stereo specific reaction is takes place here. So what happened? So you have to remember this thing. If you have Z allylic amine, you are treating with S binep. So you are ending with always alpha phase below the plane of the methyl atom or substituent. And if you start with E allylic amine, so you are ending with beta product, like amine is below the above phase. But in cross product, if you start with Z allylic amine, R binep above the product. And if you start with E allylic amine, R binep below the product. So this is the thumb rule, but I will discuss how this is happening. What are the catalytic cycle? All things I will discuss here. So this is called the catalytic asymmetric reaction. So you start with Z or E, so Z or E, you are getting this compound. So always keep in mind the alkene after the hydrolysis always make a stable product. So always you always remember that E alkene is more stable than Z. That's why this is the stereo specific product. So I will start my catalytic cycle here. So this is the rhodium, which is the 16 electron species and square planar. So what happened here? Then there's the solvent atom. So first thing happened is the ligand exchange mechanism. So what happened, ligand exchange? This one of the solvent molecules is eliminated by this allylic amine and make this compound number 31. And after this 31, this is when they undergo the beta hydrogen elimination. So this is the beta hydrogen elimination takes place. I will tell you how this elimination takes place. Like this. So we are ending with this S trans imidium ruthenium pi complex. So question is that why this is S trans? So this S trans is termed as in the vessel of this single bond. So you can see here, this is the single bond here, and this single bond of both are the transform. So that is why this is called S trans lead imidium RS pi complex. So this is very important. And after what happened, the supraphaseal hydrogen transfer from hydrogen transfer from rhodium to C3 complex. So this is the superficial hydrogen transfer that takes place here, and this go like this, and this open like this. So we are ending with this compound number 33. And in compound 33, we start, we have to eliminate this thing. So we will add the allylic amine again. We interpret complex number 34. And after addition of solvent, again, what happened there, this is ligand action takes place, and we end up with the enamine. So this is the basically catalytic asymmetric enamine hydrolysis, enamine reaction. So this is the catalytic cycle, and I hope you understand this thing. And more detail, I will tell you the reference and reference for this reaction. So you can go through the classical in total synthesis by Casey Nicolo, and this is the first volume. So if you find the more about this reaction, so there's a clearly explained the catalytic cycle and all this. So this is the classic in total synthesis by Casey Nicola in first volume. So now we have to use our thumb rule. So what happened here? So this is the E-amine, E-allylic amine treated with S-bindup. So E-allylic amine treated with S-bindup, we are ending with the compound, this above the plane. So this is the total synthesis, and we will see there how the total synthesis, how asymmetric synthesis is the tool for the total synthesis of the molecule. So start with this compound. Again, we get this one. So this is the, again, acetone is there. And you know, this is the, if we talk about this thing, so this is the our aldehyde. Now this is aldol reaction will take place in between this thing, or we are ending with this double bond. So this double bond is reduced by this H2PTC. So after that, aldol reaction will take place, hydrogen takes place, and this is the hydrogenation takes place by H2P. So we can remove this thing, and we are ending with this compound. Now we have Grignard region. So Grignard region can attack like this, and we end up with this compound. Now, you know this, alcohol is not a good living group. So what you have to do, we have a PCl3, which is act as a Lewis acid. So activate this compound is like this. Now there's the SN2 prime reaction will take place, which will be positioned like this and this. And OH will remove here. We are ending with the OSC. And this OSC is treated with NaOH, and fractional distillation which takes place and make this OS compound. Now again, we have the bind-up second rhodium catalyst for the hydrogenation. So again, what is this? This is the E-alamine. So this is E-allylic alcohol. So again, treated with this compound, so E and S bind-up. I always try to remember the thumb rule. We are ending with ME is the above side. And after the several transformation, we are ending with this compound. So this is the complete total synthesis of this molecule from the what is the key step? Key step is the catalytic asymmetric hydrogenation. So in 2001, the whole world see the power of the asymmetric synthesis. The two, three person is there: William S. Nobles, R. J. Newery, and K.B. Sarples. So all three people got Nobel Prize in chemistry from the side of the asymmetric synthesis. And William Nobles and R. J. Newery share 1/4 of the Nobel Prize, and K.B. Sarples share 1/2. And Sarples is very much famous for the Sarples asymmetric epoxidation as well as the Sarples asymmetric dihydroxylation. So due to time and all this issue, I did not cover the Sarples portion. But in upcoming session, whenever I got time, I will discuss about the Sarples asymmetric epoxidation and Sarples asymmetric hydroxylation, Tibetri region. There are several regions in asymmetric synthesis which are going to be discussed, but not now. So in 2001, the power of asymmetric synthesis, how asymmetric synthesis is very much important for this total synthesis energy, farm industry and industry, all these things. So that is why this is the very much elegant field for this research. Now, thank you all of you. And this is my final thank you. So, Now discussion seminar is open for discussion.
If anyone have any question, please ask now.
Hello.
There is a question in the chat. How okay. is the synthesis of menthol is occurring?
How the synthesis of menthol is occurring? So synthesis start from here.
How to confirm that it is not plus menthol?
How
to confirm that this is not the plus menthol? So you have shown here that this is the total synthesis of this minus menthanol. Mm-hmm. So they are asking why, how do we know that it is only the this product is forming?
Achha. So if we talk about the without anything, the characterization, if we talk about this compound, so this is the stable six member trans esterase is forming here. The molecule is transferred like this and this and this. So this is delivered by this side. So this OS is going upside. And the whole scenario, because if we draw this stable conformation of this molecule, so we are getting this one. And other thing is that if you do HPLC, chiral HPLC of this molecule, so we can separate the compounds from the which one. But basically this in this case, we are using asymmetric synthesis. So this is the beauty of the asymmetric synthesis. We can get the only one product. So this is the 98% of enantiomeric excess. So this is the that's why asymmetric synthesis is very much important, because we can control the selectivity of the molecule. So we are getting 98% enantiomeric selectivity after treated with Lewis acid. So this cyclization will take place.
So what is the structure of plus menthol? Like you have shown minus menthol here.
Okay. So if you both things here. Only because this OH will be above cell, only because of this thing. So the center change only is this carbon. So this is the minus and menthol. And if you talk about this thing, this is the plus menthol. So only one histogenic center is changed. So this is the both are the diastomers.
Okay, Rehas Ranjan is saying that L-DOPA is also used for this schizophrenia disease, a mental disorder disease.
Okay, what is the L-DOPA is used for the? So what is this question actually?
This is not a question. They are just
okay.
Saying that. Mm-hmm.
Because there are several drugs cure for the particular diseases, so that's why.
So Dr. Ramkaran sir also want to add something, please.
No, I really enjoy, especially second part, asymmetric synthesis. I yes, love sir. That. And the way you introduce that subject, I really love that. And yes, schizophrenia is a very common, like, you know, bhutia. Sometimes you see in movies also people feel like they are having some ghost inside like that. So schizophrenia is a kind of disease there, yes. So I just want to appreciate that you people are doing this thing. And even myself also, you know, especially about this lemon and orange. Honestly say, I didn't know about it. So this is really good learning. I really learned that today. So thank you so much for teaching us. So I must appreciate your efforts. It's good. But you know, I have only one suggestion, because for me, I'm joining you first time. So I suggest make it more live. You people have making it like a classroom. I think you are just research scholars and you should be make it more live. So you all must have your camera on, a mic on, sit in a silent environment and just interact. You know, when you have more interaction, then you will learn more. Just feel like you are in a classroom. Imagine when you are in a classroom, how you do that? right? In a classroom, you will talk even each slide. You don't need to wait. Just don't make it like a professor and a student interaction. That's what I feel. You are like all our students. I feel that you are either master's or PhD. So most of you are PhD and you are using it in practical knowledge. I think that's very important. And that's what even here also we used to do, like we go to each desk, we talk, and I think this is very good. But I must say that it should be more interactive. Then it will not be boring to you people. Otherwise, feel like you are in class, one person is speaking, and others are just maybe doing something else.
So what question is from for you? Okay, sir, please tell something about the biocatalysis.
No, biocatalysis, yes. So I don't need to explain that much. But biocatalysis, you know, why it's very, like you mentioned nicely in your talk, that biocatalysis is one of the most demanding things, especially when you talk about the nano selectivity. Biocatalysis is the first choice. If you think, it's fascinating. But when you talk about the practical point of view, it's not very easy. Biocatalysis is a big molecule because it's an enzyme. And the same thing, your things like when you use any normal catalyst or you use metal for any reaction, same way enzyme has amino acids. So they also work as a carbon, like a donor or acceptor, nucleophile, hydrophile. Same way they also do it. But in that, you know, I hope you know this Locke and Key hypothesis.
Yes,
so they are very specific enzymes. But what is the biggest disadvantage with the enzymes? That like most of the chemical compounds, normal enzymes are not stable in these kind of conditions. Whenever you want to use any substrate, many times in chemistry, you have to use some like DMF, DMSO, even alcohols. So enzymes are not stable. So that's what whoever is considering that way. That's why, you know, it's good to say kind of, you know, we say sustainability, we can remove chemicals from the industry by enzymes. Even I also say in my talks, but the truth is, it's not really easy. The alternative of chemistries are not easy. So it's still chemistry, the way you are using the chemistry, that is better choice. Catalysts could be utilized in theoretically way. And still there are some biocatalysts, but they are not very like vast use of them. That's why, you know, a person like me or many other are looking for the enzymes. Those can withstand in organic solvents. So that's why our selling point also that we are working kind of enzyme or biocatalyst that can be used in the organic solvents.
Yes, sir. Also temperature, our body temperature is 39, 37, 70.
Yes, exactly.
It's slightly increased by 1 degree and 2 degrees. So we are getting, bukhar aa gaya, ye sab ho gaya.
Yes, sir, that's correct. Yeah, that's why, you know, if you've been, I think, in my talk, in Delhi University talk. So basically many of us doing, we are bringing the, you know, samples from like volcano area, where it's volcanic eruption is happening, where temperature 120, 110. So we are getting the microbes from there and we are isolating the enzyme. So this is quite obvious that the enzyme will be working in this kind of conditions. So when I'm getting an enzyme from volcanic area, it means that enzyme will be working more than 100 degree temperature. So that's how those kind of things are useful in this kind of reaction you are talking about today.
Yes, sir. Because 2-3 weeks ago, I just talked to Dr. Neil Kamalsan, and he's also working chemical biology. So he was telling me what is the, so at this talk, I just talked from here. So he told me that what is the actual chemistry and what is the biochemistry. Biochemistry is very good, but in normal condition, when you put reaction in laboratory and all these things, so this could not happen like this, what you are thinking.
So, yes, exactly. So that's why Dr. Neem Kamal also working on extremophiles. And yes, he's more interested to use our enzymes for the chemical synthesis.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Yeah, that's a good, you know, that's why he got the position, got position in IIT. Because this field is very demanding these days. Like, yes, you know, these days chemistry, you know, almost everything is being like you use by chemicals. Everything you synthesize, you need the chemicals. But then after the synthesis, there's what about the side product, right? So what are the waste products? So it's very hard to neutralize them. So that's the biggest concern. You make something, but whatever you like side product or waste product, it has a big impact on the environment, negative impact basically. So that's why people are trying to remove these chemicals with enzymes or protein, because they are biodegradable. But it's not very, I must say that's not very easy job. But you talk about you simply Google Nozymes. Nozymes is a $1 billion company. So they are investing more research, and people like you, you can look for Nozyme, people who are looking for like biocatalysis enzymes or biochemistry, you should look for the Nozyme website. And there you will learn more about the enzymes. I think the campus is biggest campus is in India, in Bangalore.
Okay, sir. Thank you. So, Shubham, there is a message from Archana Yadav. Thank you, Shubham. I really enjoyed the asymmetric synthesis part. Looking forward for more sessions like this. Thank you, Archana.
Thanks, Archana. Actually, when we start this session like this, so we start like we all student from the IIT Kanpur started talking like this because I introduce asymmetric synthesis. Likewise, other guy will introduce other topics. So we will create some scientific temperament so that our the students who are from the master and who are in the PhD, because I belong to organic portion, but I don't know much about the inorganic physical and biology and all these things. So that we can circulate the knowledge all about them. So this is my particular theme, but how it will work, and let's see, but our theme is like that. So Archana will start a new session, and surely we will let you know soon.
Yeah, no, I to everyone, because you know, I just joined today just to see you all and just say to hi to you, and appreciate Nitin and Shubham efforts. Just I want to see that how things going with you people, and if any way I could be help, I'll be more than happy. But to every students, I really want to mention that, you know, where are you now today? I was there in 15 years ago, almost 16 years ago. So I was in the same place. So I want to tell you that with my experience being from IIT Delhi, then being in USA, then being in Germany, being in Japan, Italy, and now in Saudi Arabia. And I've been involved in several panel as interview and interviewer and as a candidate also. So I want to mention you people that this is the way you are doing. This is really, really very good and very important thing. One way you are sharpening your knowledge and also your teaching aptitude. You know, if you want to learn something, teach others. So Shubham, I really must say that you people always think that always, I don't know, many of you may be some of my talks. So always, whenever you present anything, just think how like what could be the easiest way you can teach anyone. Can you put animation? Can you make some story? Or like, can you put some pictures kind of things? Can you make some video? So try to make that way. And then you have to think through. You cannot make these kind of things until otherwise you know the full subject. And once you have the full knowledge of that, then you start thinking that way. And with that, because you know, if you, let's say, for example, you did your PhD, what you will do after that? You go for, let's say you are going for postdoc. Even whenever you come up, you have to come for the either teaching or for the research. And almost everywhere, whether it's ICER, whether it's NIT, whether or IIT, everywhere you have to teach. And if you have this kind of, you know, I can tell you, I went in 2015. I went in interview of Central University of Haryana. So they simply just gave me the chalk and duster and asked me to teach some chemical reactions. So like even whatever you are teaching today, it's really important for you also. And even if you go, when I went for the PhD interview in IIT Delhi, there also they asked me to, I think if I remember correctly, they asked me to draw the mechanism of chymotrypsin, because there I choose as a biochemistry. And when I've been in interview in ISC Bangalore, I don't know if any one of you are MSc also. So it doesn't matter. You are in MSc, you are in PhD. Everywhere, teaching skills are very important. So get the good habit. And I'm sure, I think now 25 of you are available here. Everyone is must be in master. You know, in every class, there is every student know very good in each subject, anything. So you just teach their subject. So you even if you are master, you are PhD, choose like even bachelor and master topic also. And then you slowly become the master in that.
Yes, sir. In morning when I watch your slides and all these things, so I thought that